on hand right now for the event banner, and then I've got 3,641 primigems right now, which is equal to... I'm not sure what that's equal to. Let's find out. It's not a lot of pulls, I'm sure, but 3,641 is equal to 22 pulls. That's not too bad. If you count that onto what I've got right now, that's 20, 30, that's... Wait, really? That's 40 pulls. In total that I would have, which is obviously not great. It's not even half of pity, since that would be 45, but it's at least a start. So overall, I'd have to say that with these two banners that they're running, I don't think, without spending a ridiculous amount of money, which I do not want to do, I don't think I would be able to do both banners. I would at the very least be able to do one banner and go to at least get to my 5-star and then be done with it. That's the only thing I can think of. And unfortunately, as we've already established prior, I'm not guaranteed the event character on my next 5-star, so I could get totally butt-fucked on this. It sucks to have to pass up another character again, but at least it's a character we've missed before, and at least the character we would be getting if we get an event character is one that we have previously missed. And I will be, of course, trying, as should be no surprise to anyone, will be Yola, or whatever her name is. She would be the banner that I would be pulling on. And as for the weapon banner, I won't be pulling on this, as much as I would like to, because these swords look pretty badass. I unfortunately will not be pulling on this particular banner. And then, of course, we'll have a handful of pulls here to do for the standard banner. But yeah, and again, as we've said before, the only way that I could possibly get a 5-star character on both banners would be if I literally did like one pull and got a 5-star on the first pull, and then it happened to be the event character and I was just that lucky, and then I could go and put the rest of my pulls into the other banner. That's the only possibility without spending ridiculous amounts of cash. And of course, the 4-star characters that are here, we have Noelle, who we've already completed, so that's just additional glitter for us. And then Rosaria and Bennett, and I don't know where I sit with Rosaria and Bennett in terms of constellations. Let's see. I think I've got a few for Rosaria. What does she look like? Right there she is. So, constellation. Yeah, so I can get two additional Rosarias to be complete with her and for Bennett. Who's literally at the very end. Again, also two for his completion. Although people have warned me about getting his C6, but I honestly don't think I care, because I don't think I'm ever going to use him for like at least 3 more years. And that goes for most of the male characters. Although I've always had a plan to make a male party, just to counter the fact that I've played with females this entire time. Ah, the good old days, as you know. So... that's the end of that, and I suppose this is where I'll call it quits, and we can look forward to moving on. I won't be doing the battle pass, I don't think, for this month either, because I just don't think I can progress far enough in it. There's apparently... oh, that's the dog event. I was going to say there's apparently something here that we can do, but no. Yeah, I mean, we might be able to progress far enough in it. I would probably be able, in the 21 days, I'd most likely be able to at least get the weapon. I don't even remember what I got last time. I think I got the sword or something. I don't remember. Or maybe the bow, I'm not sure. But either way, that's how that is. And I guess that's where we're ending it. So I will see you guys in the next episode of Let's Play Genshin Impact. New mail. Oh no, that's just because we did the survey thing. Okay.